गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन द इंट्रोडक्शन टू एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द केमिकल मेथड्स ऑफ क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस एंड द केमिकल मेथड्स ऑफ क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस. एज यू नो, द एनालिसिस इज क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप्स, क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस एंड क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस. So qualitative analysis is that type of analysis in which we determine, in which we find the quality of a sample. Quality of a sample means what is exactly there in the sample, what is present in the sample, that we have to determine. That is known as the qualitative analysis. Second analysis is the quantitative analysis, and in the quantitative analysis we already know what is there in the sample. Just we have to find out what is the quantity of that substance present in the sample. If we determine, if we find out the quantity of the sample, quantity of the substance in that sample, then that is called as the quantitative analysis. Means in the quantitative analysis we determine how much is present in that sample. That is known as the quantitative analysis. So today we are going to study the chemical methods of qualitative analysis and the chemical methods of quantitative analysis. So first, the chemical methods of qualitative analysis. In the chemical methods of qualitative analysis, there are two types of methods: dry methods and the wet methods. Wet methods. The dry methods involve the use of dry sample, the sample which is to be tested, the sample which is to be analyzed, which is to be tested. That sample is not dissolved in any solvent. That is taken in the dry condition. The sample is taken in the dry state. And if the sample is taken in the dry state and various reactions are carried out, then such analysis, such method is known as the dry methods. Second type of methods are the wet methods. In the wet methods, the sample which is to be tested, the sample which is to be analyzed, that sample is first of all dissolved in a suitable solvent to give it solution. Means sample is converted to the solution by dissolving that sample in a suitable solvent. And later on, that solution is used to perform the various tests. That solution is used to perform various reactions or various tests. These methods are called the wet methods. So dry methods and wet methods, these two types of methods are used in the qualitative analysis. The dry methods are generally used as a preliminary test. Preliminary tests. In any analysis, there are some preliminary tests. Preliminary means primary. These tests, preliminary, prathamik, in Hindi or in Marathi, what we say, prathamik. In the preliminary test, there is a use of the dry methods. And these wet methods, these wet methods are used as the confirmatory tests. Confirmation. Confirmation is carried out with the help of the wet methods. And the dry methods are just the preliminary methods or preliminary tests. Now here, in the chemical methods of qualitative analysis, there is a use of apparatus. There is a use of apparatus such as the test tubes, measuring cylinder, then there is a use of watch glass, then there is a use of burner, blow pipe, then there is the use of wire gauge, then a crucible, evaporating, this evaporating, this is required there. Then centrifuge, centrifuge machine. These are the various apparatus. These are the various glassware and apparatus which are used in the chemical methods of qualitative analysis. Many more apparatus are used: test tubes, measuring cylinder, watch glass, burner, blow pipe, wire gauge, crucibles. Evaporating dish. Evaporating dish is a dish or a bowl in which we take a solution which is to be evaporated. Evaporating this, centrifuge machine. These are the various apparatus or devices which are used in the chemical methods of qualitative analysis. Now the qualitative analysis of organic compounds. Qualitative analysis of qualitative analysis of organic compounds. If we have to perform the qualitative analysis of organic compound, then we know that most of the organic compounds contain the elements such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, and halogens. These are the various elements which are present in the organic compounds. In the qualitative analysis of organic compounds, two types of analysis are carried out. Number one, element detection. Element detection. Detection of elements in the given organic compound. The organic compound or the sample is taken. In that sample, which elements are present? Out of these elements, which elements are present in that sample or in that organic compound? Means element detection is carried out in the qualitative analysis of organic compounds. And second, identification of that compound. Identification of organic compound. That organic compound is to be identified, and the identification of organic compound is possible by the detection of functional group. Detection of functional group. You must know, in an organic compound, there is a particular group which is known as the functional group. That functional group gives specific physical and chemical properties to that organic compound. And that functional group is to be detected. Detection of functional group. After the detection of functional group, we can identify which organic compound is there in the given sample. In the given sample, which organic compound is present? It could be identified after the detection of the functional group. Functional group detection, then determination of melting point of that compound. Melting point, boiling point. So these are the various steps, or these are the various tests for the identification of organic compound in the given sample. So in the qualitative analysis of any organic compound, first of all, we have to perform the element detection. Element detection means in that organic compound, in that sample of organic compound, which elements are present, whether there is a presence of carbon or not, nitrogen is present or not, oxygen is present or not, sulfur is there or not. In this way, the element should be detected first of all. In any sample of organic compound, first of all, detect the elements. Find out the elements which are present in the organic compound. Later on, identification of the organic compound. Then identify which organic compound is there in the given sample. And for this purpose, we have to find out the functional group present in the organic compound. And the functional group determination as well as determination of melting point and boiling point. These are the various steps by which we can identify the organic compound present in the given sample. Then, the qualitative analysis of simple inorganic compounds. If we have a sample of inorganic compound, if we have a sample of inorganic compound, then the qualitative analysis of that sample of inorganic compound is carried out by determination of the cation and anion present in that inorganic compound. Detection and confirmation of cation and anion present in the given inorganic compound, in the given sample. Suppose we have a sample of inorganic compound. For the qualitative analysis of that inorganic compound, we must first of all identify which cation is there and which anion is there. You might know the meaning of cation and anion. Cation is the positively charged ion, anion is the negatively charged ion. So in the qualitative analysis of inorganic compound, it is necessary to detect, it is necessary to confirm which cation is there as well as which anion is there in that inorganic compound. The cation is also called the basic radical, and the anion is also called the acidic radical. So acidic radical and basic radical in the given inorganic compound must be identified or must be detected. And after the detection of the cation and anion, that is the basic and acidic radical in that sample, we can perform the qualitative analysis of that inorganic compound. So in the qualitative analysis of the inorganic compound, it is necessary to detect or it is necessary to find out the cation and anion present in the given sample of inorganic compound. Then the chemical methods of quantitative analysis. Chemical methods of quantitative analysis. Now, quantitative analysis is the type of analysis in which we find the quantity of the particular component of a given sample. In a given sample, what is the quantity of any component, that we have to determine. That is known as the quantitative analysis. So in the chemical methods of quantitative analysis, it is necessary to measure some physical properties. Measurement of physical properties such as mass and volume. We have to measure the mass or volume by using the apparatus such as weighing machine and burette. With the help of burette, we can measure the volume. With the help of weighing machine, we can measure the mass. So measurement of mass or volume is required or it is necessary in the chemical methods of quantitative analysis. In the chemical method of quantitative analysis, what we measure? We measure the mass as well as we measure the volume. And for the measurement of mass and volume, we need to use the apparatus such as the weighing machine. You know the weighing machine and the burette. These are the apparatus which are used for the measurement of the mass and volume. And it is to be measured. Mass and volume must be measured in the chemical methods of quantitative analysis. In the quantitative analysis of organic compounds. In the quantitative analysis of organic compounds, here we have to perform the element detection for determination of percentage composition. Determination of percentage composition. Percentage composition is determined. Means here, already we know the elements. Which elements are present in the organic compound? We know that there is a presence of carbon, there is a presence of hydrogen, there is a presence of oxygen. But we don't know what is their percentage, what is their quantity. So in the quantitative analysis of organic compounds, we determine the percentage of carbon, percentage of hydrogen, percentage of oxygen. In this way, in the quantitative analysis, we determine the percentage composition. Already in the qualitative analysis, we know that there is a presence of carbon, there is a presence of hydrogen, there is a presence of oxygen. Presence or absence of elements is known from the qualitative analysis, but the quantity or the percentage of these elements is known from the quantitative analysis. In the quantitative analysis of organic compounds, there is a determination of the percentage composition, means there is a determination of the percentage of various elements which are found in that organic compound. As well as the concentration of a compound, known compound, concentration of a known compound in a sample. If we have a sample of organic compound, then what we do in the quantitative analysis, we concentrate that sample. For the concentration, the sample is taken in the evaporating dish. This is the evaporating dish, and then this is the burner. With the help of this burner, there is the evaporation of that sample. And after the evaporation of the sample, what happened? Water is lost in the form of vapors. From that sample, there is a loss of water vapors, and here what remains? The compound remains. So this is known as the concentration of the compound. Known compound. Known compound means here already we know what compound is there, which compound is there in the sample. Already we know which compound is there in the sample. Just here we have to concentrate that compound. We have to accumulate or gather that compound here, collect that compound here. And for that purpose, we have to evaporate that sample. So concentration of the known compound in a sample, it is also the part of the quantitative analysis of organic compound. Then the quantitative analysis of inorganic compound. In the quantitative analysis of inorganic compound, two types of methods are used. One is the gravimetric analysis, and other is the volumetric analysis. These are the two methods which are used in the quantitative analysis of inorganic compounds. Gravimetric analysis. What happened exactly in the gravimetric analysis here? In the gravimetric analysis, this is one solution, clear and transparent solution, no solid is there. In this solution, another solution is poured. This solution is also clear and transparent, no solid is there, no solid particles. For example, here we have a solution of NaCl, and this is the solution of silver nitrate. These are the two solutions. Both the solutions are clear and transparent. After mixing these two solutions, there is a formation of solid here. Solid substance is produced. This solid, that is the insoluble substance, is known as the precipitate. This insoluble substance is known as the precipitate. So in gravimetric analysis, what we do? We prepare the precipitate. After the preparation of the precipitate, after the formation of the solid substance or precipitate, what we do? We then filter with the help of the funnel. This is the funnel, this is the filter paper. We pour this complete solution here. We filter the precipitate. After filtration of the precipitate, this precipitate is later dried. It should become dry. It is dried. And after drying, it is weighed. Weighing, वजन करना, इसका वजन कितना, मास कितना, वो मास निकाला जाएगा. मास इज डिटरमाइंड, मास ऑफ द प्रेसिपिटेट इज डिटरमाइंड हियर. एंड फ्रॉम द मास ऑफ द प्रेसिपिटेट, आफ्टर मेजरिंग, आफ्टर डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ द मास ऑफ द प्रेसिपिटेट, हाउ मच कंपाउंड वॉज देयर, हाउ मच सब्सटेंस वॉज देयर इन द गिवन सैंपल, दैट वी नो. We know the amount of substance present in that sample. We know the amount of the substance present in that sample, quantity of the substance present in that sample, after knowing or after determination of the mass of that precipitate. So, this is known as the gravimetric analysis. In the gravimetric analysis, there is a decomposition reaction. Decomposition occur. AgNO3 as well as NaCl both get decomposed and there is a formation of the new substance, that is the precipitate AgCl. AgCl is a new substance which is produced from NaCl and AgNO3. So decomposition reactions are taking place here in the gravimetric analysis. So gravimetric analysis is very clear. In the gravimetric analysis, two solutions which are clear and transparent are mixed together. There is a formation of insoluble substance, solid, which is known as the precipitate. After that, the precipitate is filtered. The precipitate is later dried. And after dry, when it will become dry, its mass is determined. Weighing is carried out. Weighing. Mass is determined. And from the mass of the precipitate, we come to know what is the quantity of that substance in the given sample. This is the sample, suppose. In that sample, what is the quantity of the substance that can be determined? So this is the gravimetric analysis. It is one of the type of quantitative analysis of inorganic compound. And second type of quantitative analysis of the inorganic compound is the volumetric analysis. In the volumetric analysis, the reaction is carried out between two solutions. The reaction is carried out between two solutions. One solution is taken in the conical flask. Other solution is taken in the burette. Other solution is taken in the burette. This is the conical flask. One solution is taken here. Other solution is taken in the burette. And then the reaction is carried out between them. The reaction is carried out between these two solutions until that reaction you get completed. Until the completion of the reaction, these two are reacted with each other. These two solutions are added with each other, mixed with each other until the reaction get completed. And when the reaction will get completed, the volume of the solution is measured. Volume of the solution in the burette is measured. How much solution from the burette is required for the completion of the reaction with the solution taken in the conical flask. Ye jo conical flask mein solution liya gaya hai, iske saath mein reaction puri karne ke liye, यहां पे ब्यूरेट में जो सॉल्यूशन लिया गया है उसकी कितनी क्वांटिटी लग रही है, कितना एमएल सॉल्यूशन लग रहा है, तो ब्यूरेट के ऊपर से यहां पे मेजर किया जाएगा हाउ मच सॉल्यूशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. मींस यहां पे अपन वॉल्यूम का मेजरमेंट कर रहे हैं. एंड आफ्टर मेजरिंग द वॉल्यूम वी डिटरमाइन हियर व्हाट इज द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द सैंपल, व्हाट इज द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द सब्सटेंस टेकन इन द सैंपल, गिवन इन द सैंपल. ये जो सैंपल है, इस सैंपल के अंदर उस पर्टिकुलर सब्सटेंस की क्वांटिटी कितनी है, ये अपने को काय के ऊपर से पता चलेगा, ये वॉल्यूम के ऊपर से. तो इसको बोला जाता है वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एनालिसिस और टाइट्रीमेट्रिक एनालिसिस. अनदर नेम इज टाइट्रीमेट्रिक एनालिसिस, वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एनालिसिस और टाइट्रीमेट्रिक एनालिसिस. और ये जो एक्सपेरिमेंट होता है, इस एक्सपेरिमेंट का नाम होता है टाइट्रेशन. अपन टाइट्रेशन करते हैं. टाइट्रेशन करने से क्या मालूम होता है, यहां पे एक ये जो दो सोल्यूशन है, इन दो सोल्यूशन में से एक सोल्यूशन का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन जो है ऑलरेडी पता होता है, नोन होता है, और दूसरे सोल्यूशन का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन अननोन रहता है. तो ये जो अननोन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन वाला जो सोल्यूशन है, उसका कॉन्सेंट्रेशन कैसे क्या मालूम हो जाता है, यहां पे टाइट्रेशन परफॉर्म करना पड़ता है. ब्यूरेट में से सोल्यूशन डालते जाओ, कब तक डालेंगे, जब तक यहां पे रिएक्शन पूरी नहीं हो जाती. अब रिएक्शन पूरी हो गई करके कैसे पता चलता है, यहां पे कलर चेंज हो जाता है इंडिकेटर के द्वारा, कलर चेंज हो गया इसका मतलब रिएक्शन कंप्लीट हो गई. और रिएक्शन पूरी हो जाने के बाद में यहाँ पे ब्यूरेट के ऊपर से रीडिंग नोट करेंगे, कितना सॉल्यूशन लगा ब्यूरेट में से, और उस सॉल्यूशन के वॉल्यूम के ऊपर से यहाँ पे पता चलता है कि ये जो सैंपल दिया गया था, इस सैंपल में पर्टिकुलर सब्सटेंस की क्वांटिटी कितनी थी. तो ये बोलेंगे इसको वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एनालिसिस. सो वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एनालिसिस एंड ग्रेविमेट्रिक एनालिसिस, दीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस विच आर यूज फॉर द इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड. थैंक यू.